I'm going to do it now, so bye.
Bye.
Was that the missus?
Yeah.
Did you tell her it was worth coming?
Yeah, I did. Oh, she's got the baby.
Congratulations on that one, by the way, mate.
Cheers.
Congratulations, Matt Smith. I was going to say more importantly, but not more importantly. Well done, nah, seriously.
Yeah. Cheers, mate.
Another lion on board.
I know.
If that was his first ever away game, he'd be expecting that every week.
Oh, he's got. They've made him like all these placards at home. The best thing is that my father-in-law's a Tottenham fan, so he's been down there. He's seen them lose to Norwich. He's seen us win 3-0, Dan. So quality. What? Yeah.
Mate, you shell-shocked. The fans were shell-shocked. I think we was half shell-shocked. What a fucking first half performance. What a performance.
It was like the complete performance in the first half, really, wasn't it? Like Woods and Malumbi just running the midfield, Jed doing all of his runs, and Matt Smith popping up with three goals, even though apparently he's shit.
I think someone said he wouldn't hit double figures this year. I don't know who that fucking idiot was.
I know, probably QPR, they let him go.
Mate, just unbelievable. But we know now, I think a lot of us knew the team were capable of that anyway. Did you not think? But we need to show a level of consistency now. Now they've given it to us, they've got to keep it now.
I think, Dan, I was listening to a podcast on the way up here, the Acton Millwall one.
Great podcast. Think,
yeah,
shout out to Nick.
Yeah, shout out to Nick. But, you know, a lot of people were talking about why does he keep chopping, changing the side, yeah, things like that. But if you look at the size of our squad, if you look, he's got to rotate and rest players.
Yeah.
So we've got that inconsistency sometimes, I think, because we've got such a small squad and we've got to rest players. But tonight, I love the fact he started Bennett. I mean, he run his arse off, didn't he? He looked knackered when he come off, I mean, after 60 minutes. Fair play to him.
He's still a little bit away from full fitness, but you can see what there's a player in there.
Oh, definitely. I think so. I thought...
Shane Ferguson?
Yeah, quality.
Go on, let me have the Shane Ferguson.
Yeah, Shane Ferguson, I thought, had a brilliant game.
He did, he really
tonight.
Did.
Run everything down. Some really good touches. Great passes in the first half into space down the side, taking on a couple of players. Yeah.
The moves for the goal, it was just frightening. Movement off the ball. We wasn't one-dimensional. We was getting into good areas.
Yeah.
And it's, mate, just... Wow, just fucking wow. In the second half, me and you just stood looking at the Forest fans just waving fingers at them. And then back at us.
I mean, I thought, you know, I don't know what Forest were just so off the pace tonight, because I thought we gave away a lot of possession in the second half. I don't think we stood off them. I think they just started to try and play football a bit more. But they definitely, you know, you could see they're a skillful side, Dan. I mean, you don't, what, are they fourth in the table or something?
Yeah, they're a good side, mate.
Yeah, unbelievable. They beat Leeds. But it's the championship curse. Anyone could beat anyone on the day.
True.
Up to seventh tonight.
Yeah, mate.
Unbelievable.
Dare we dream.
Hey, Super Neil Harris.
You wanted him gone. He'd done a good job for us. But this is, to me now, this is next level shit. And the players showed tonight what I knew they was capable of under Rowett.
Well, I think as well, we've still got Ben Thompson to come back from injury to have a holding midfielder. I know we're going to lose Malumbi probably at the end of the season. He'll go back to Brighton.
And good was he as well.
Oh, yeah, he played well. Everyone started singing songs. But like I said, he's going back to Brighton, so I'm not going to sing for him.
Fair enough. But, mate, he was sensational. The whole team throughout was sensational. And for me as well, the two players that Rowett signed since he's been at the club, Bennett and Woods, are looking very strong. Bennett still needs a little bit more fitness.
Yeah, definitely. But I think he'll be a quality striker. He's something to prove as well. It's great when you've got a player like that. He ran everywhere tonight. And I thought just because it's Forrest and he's next Derby boy, obviously. Derby, yeah, you know, I thought that could be a difference.
That was an extra kick in the bollocks for them. They was livid, rightly so. It was an absolute demolition job from start to finish. Can we make the playoffs?
Well, I don't see why not, but then we've got Derby next week and we'll draw 1-1. So, yes, Dan, we can make the playoffs, but if we can get that consistency, and I do worry about the squad size, what, we've got 9 games left now, but you've got to, mate, as a Millwall fan, you've got to enjoy these moments, and I think when I see you at half-time, I said, how much is a 4-3 Forest win? Because you've still...
At 90 minutes, you wanted to see how long was left before you would say if we still win or not.
Yeah, just been here too long, that Brentford game, like I said earlier in the season, you just don't know, but...
Still wake up in cold sweats over that Brentford game, do you?
Bloody fucking...
But, mate, listen, let's enjoy tonight. Yeah, thanks for stopping back.
No problem at all.
Come on, you lines. Congratulations on...
Come on, you lines.
Come on, you lines.
Edward Morgan. Have it. Edward Morgan. First game watching, son. 3-0. Have that.